Welcome to our MES video about the MES Model Examiner. In this video, we will demonstrate how to set up an MXM project as an MXMP file. You will learn how to create and configure an MXM project and how to save and load a project. You will need to have basic knowledge about the MXM workflow to watch this video, as it's focused on the first step of the workflow. An MXM project represents the basis of each analysis, because it contains important configurations for guideline checking. Creating a new project can be done by using the menu options File, New, or simply the shortcut Ctrl plus N. In the wizard, browse the project entry and select MXM Project. We're going to choose the name MXM Guideline Project Demo and also specify the file name. MXM uses validation markers to draw your attention to invalid or incomplete settings. Here we can see that we need to select a directory where the project will be stored. To do so, you can simply copy and paste a directory path, or you can click on the Browse button. I will select the desktop here for demonstration purposes. By clicking on Finish, you create the new project, MXM Guideline Project Demo. In the section down below, you can see a list of recently used projects. When you click on the name, the project will load. On the right-hand side, there is an overview with general information such as MXM and license, version and use, as well as information on the project setup. In order to configure your project, go to the Settings page. The Settings page consists of seven different headings. In General Settings, you can see the directory where the project file is archived, and you can also change the project's title here. In addition, you can decide whether the access to your project should be restricted, or whether it will be made public, so that each user can make changes to the project. If you choose restricted access, only the managers, which you can add here, will be allowed to make changes to your project. The second step is to choose a guideline document, which contains all the guidelines your model should be compliant with. As we can see in the tooltip, there is currently no document referenced in the project. It's worth noting, you can also see that in the validation view on the right-hand side, where MXM provides us with general information about configurations that are missing, inconsistent, or just additional information. In this case, it's necessary to specify a guideline document. In order to do so, click on the Add button. The pop-up dialog shows all available guideline documents that are shipped with MXM, as well as customized guideline documents. Using the filter, you can quickly find the desired guideline document. We will use the MXM starter set document here. By clicking on Finish, the document is added to the project. Of course, you can also reference multiple guideline documents in one project. Or you can remove already added documents. By saving the project, you can see that the project settings are validated again and that the guideline documents are correctly configured now. In the next section, you can determine fix artifacts that should be analyzed with this project. An artifact definition contains one or multiple models. It will be attached to your project and automatically load whenever you open your project. To define a new artifact definition for your project, go to the Overview section and click on the Add button. Choose the corresponding models and click on Finish. Then you can save the artifact definition and add it to your project. As you can see, the artifact definition is now listed in the project settings. However, you can also add an already existing artifact definition by using the respective menu option and browsing to the correct file. Using these artifact definitions saves time. For instance, if you want to check the quality status of several models at the same time. However, if you want the users to be able to define for themselves which model or model part should be analyzed, leave this section blank. The next configuration contains ignore lists, which you can create to mark findings on specific model parts as ignored automatically. This will be explained in a different video. The Libraries section allows you to configure project-specific locations of customer libraries. This can be useful if the library content should be defined in a location other than the MXAM installation folder. In the report settings, you can configure what the report should look like. In most cases, it's sufficient to use the compact HTML format. When exporting the report, the dynamic tokens allow you to generate a report name containing the corresponding information regarding the project, model, and date. The last setting involves annotations. The use of annotations will be shown in another video. We recommend to store the annotations file in a directory next to the artifact, that is the model. You can also define a directory that is relative to your artifact location. After you've completed the project settings, don't forget to save the file. You have now successfully created and saved your first MXM project. It's worth noting you can also load another existing project using the respective menu options, or you can drag and drop an MXMP file from the System Explorer. We hope you found this video useful. Thank you very much for joining us today.